Today we'll discuss Gage R&R in MSA with its Excel template. Hi, this is Mike Negami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. This time I received a video request from one of my viewers. Please make a video on calibration. Calibration of measuring gauges, sir. Thanks, Seka. Calibration is to adjust the readout deviations of measuring devices. It's important to work on things scientifically based on data. This is especially true in Lean Sigma and SPC, Statistical Process Control. However, what if those data are wrong? All decisions based on those data will be mistakes, and they will most likely cause failures. So, for SPC, it's an imperative practice to ensure that you are collecting the correct data. Therefore, in SPC, we use MSA, Measurement System Analysis. I made a video about this topic in the past, so please click the link above and watch the video. I'll introduce Gage R&R, the most common method of MSA. I will explain a very difficult topic in an easy-to-understand manner without using any formulas. I made an Excel template, so I'll explain this topic along with the template. When you conduct the Gage R&R, you can see if there is a problem with the operator or measuring device in your measurement system. If it's your measuring device, you need to calibrate it. The method of calibration depends on each device. Also, depending on your industry, you may have a set standardization. For component manufacturing companies, their clients may require them to submit proof of their MSA. At that time, they may submit their record of Gage R&R. Let's look at the Gage R&R template now. There is a link to download the template in this video description. Click it. This is the template, and on the right side, it shows the instructions for how to conduct the Gage R&R analysis. First, decide the measurement standard. Usually, three appraisers measure 10 different parts 3 times each, but you may need to change that according to your industry or customer's request. When choosing your parts, it may sound strange, but choose the parts so as to increase their variation. If your parts didn't have enough variation and your measurements were all about the same, your analysis result would look like worse than it actually is. The purpose here is not to make good products, but to find the good or bad of your measurement method. Also, have the people who normally do the job be the appraisers here. Next, have the appraisers measure each part in random order and input all measurements into the sampling measurement results section. I'll copy and paste my sample data. Then the calculation results are already down below. Let Excel do the difficult calculations. For example, here are the three measurements for part 1 by appraiser 1. And these are the results of 10 parts. This is done by 3 appraisers. Gage R&R's R&R stands for repeatability and reproducibility. For example, if the same appraisers measure the same parts with the same measuring devices, they should get the same measurements. However, if that's not the case, its repeatability is bad, also we'll consider their total variation as repeatability. If other appraisers measure the same parts, they are supposed to obtain the same measurement as well. If that's not the case, its reproducibility is bad. will consider that variation among the appraiser's averages as reproducibility. There are a few kinds of gauge R&R. This template uses ANOVA, analysis of variance. Generally speaking, this method is the most accurate. This is the result of ANOVA and the gauge R&R below. I'll give you a very rough explanation of what they have done. The sum of the variations of repeatability and reproducibility is called the total gauge R&R. Then, by comparing it with the total variation, this appraises your measurement system as good or bad. The last section, statistical interpretation, is the most important. It says 21.48%. It means that the variation of your measurement system accounts for 21.48% against the total variation. The guidelines for each KPI are shown in the instructions, and each result is given here too. If it's under 10%, your measurement system is acceptable. But if it's 10% or more, you must improve it. In that case, the cells here turn blue. You should compare repeatability and reproducibility there. In this example, since the variation of repeatability is higher, the advice given here is your measuring equipment may need calibration or maintenance. Lastly, from the result of the pink cell here, you are getting other advice. If this number is 5 or more, this analysis is reliable at this time. But if it's 4 or less, the parts you used didn't have enough variation, use another set of parts. We discussed MSA's gauge R&R today. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.